John 17, the most important. And only you, the only one, get to do it. I heard the parable guy say that if you have the face of a mustard seed, you could move mountains. Well, I'll put this game to the test. I didn't have an air to mustard seeds. Oh, finally. But right here, as you've seen, a part of the blood stirred. It's good for us. I didn't have any mountains at all, we do. But this panel is justified to stand the distance. If my investigations are right, the mud tube and the piano are all in my mind, which is very smart. Now, move the piano all by itself. Ready? What? Use support? Maybe it takes a few minutes, seconds.
No, you stop! Jesus is saying that if you have faith in God, even a small, tiny bit, you can do great things, like move mountains. Or in this case, move the atoms.
Then, wait, you said the man's name was?
Jesus of Nazareth.
That is a very important piece of information. Thank you, little girl. Here, you'll be more done. This part of the mustard. Good work, girl. Go on.
I'd sent him into the seediest part of the town, to get the scoop from the locals. When I arrived, I found something I had never expected to see. I knew he was undercover, so I had to get his attention in a way that wouldn't compromise his disguise. Watson! Come here, I need you!
I'm here with you!
My goodness, old boy, what is that colorful ensemble you're wearing?
The quiz on Facebook said that bright colors were good for my skin.
I met the whole tourist list, and it's not just you, but everyone here. Wait a second. I've seen these people before. Her I booked on many 554s. And him over there, he's had his hand caught in the cookie jar too many times. All these people are the highlights of the lowlife in our town, and I've never seen them this happy or clean.
Everything's been different since the teacher came to visit. Some of the members of this crowd, well, have completely turned around.
What did the teacher say that changed them in this way?
One of them asked what he needed to inherit eternal life. The teacher said, as quoted from the book of Deuteronomy, just love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your entire mind. Just love your neighbor as yourself.
I see. Well, Watson, who is the man's neighbor?
That is precisely what the crowd asked, so he responded.
With a parable.
I learned from my dear Friday, and this is the story he told. There once was a man strolling along the beach, enjoying the beautiful blue skies and the rolling waves.
Man, this would be a totally awesome place for a vacation.
Pop. About morning, a thief ran after him, hit him over the head with a coconut, after he stole his bread.
Shh.
Whoa.
Great pain in agony. There was no possible way he'd be able to get help all by himself. Soon after, the righteous dude came along.
Watson, don't you mean a righteous man?
No, he means me, the righteous dude! Because my serving is so totally righteous! Oh yeah!
His serving is totally awesome!
And his hair!
Hey, anything you can help brother out down here?
Me? Help you? Me, the totally awesome king of the waves? With 5 pro surfing championship titles? And sponsored by Alflac, Prozac, Mr. Clean, Pepto-Bismol, and L'Oreal.
Because I'm worth it.
And who here here has a space on every cereal box in the supermarket. Can he help you? So totally not!
What? Why not?
Because I'm just like too righteous to be seen, like touching the likes of you. I mean, you might get dirt on me or something.
But come on.
Now if you'll excuse me, I have to go to a Save the Puppy, Save the World convention. Catch you later, dude! Yeah! High five! Yeah!
Well, that one fellow wouldn't stop to help. But surely something's come along, right?
Yes, she did.
Hello, everyone! Isn't it a wonderful day here at this wonderful beach, which is at... I don't know. I forgot what beach I was visiting today. Anyways, wherever we are in the world, it's a beautiful place full of beautiful people.
Excuse me, miss.
Yes, what? Well, this beach was beautiful, so somebody let this dying man on it. Ew. Someone better clean this.
Yeah, someone really, really needs to clean it up. Yeah, I really need this deafening and some spots, ruining this beautiful, beautiful beach. Maybe you can help.
Me? Help you? Well, you see, I can't because, I'm a U.S. American, and I personally believe U.S. Americans are unable to do so because, some people out there in our nation don't have maps, and, I believe our education, such as South Africa and the Iraq, everywhere like such as, and I believe they should, our education over here in the U.S. should help the U.S. It should help South Africa and Iraq and the Asian countries, so we will be able to build up our future for us.
One question. What is that supposed to mean?
I have no idea.
I think someone battled out a little too much hairspray.
No one can help this poor man.
No one at all.
Like you said, I'm gonna die out here.
As soon as he had lost all hope, one more man came down the beach. This man was from the neighboring island of Samaria. Samaritans were the best of nations. They didn't stop to speak to each other or even look at each other.
As you said, those other guys wouldn't help me. Samaritans definitely wouldn't.
Oh, I might. Are you okay? What happened to you? What's your trouble? Get up. I'll be surfing for that. Yeah, there's a hospital in the next mile. But the doctor's picking up a big mate.
He took the man to the hospital and paid all the expenses.
Hey, thank you so much,
you're
Samaritan.
You're welcome, mate.
Samaritan, why would you help me?
What kind of crikey name you would like? Be fighting and God wants us to be neighbors and brothers. So all I mean is love them as we love ourselves.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
needed to find out who he was and where he was from.